Hello and welcome to the YouTube channel of Chamili Devi Institute of Pharmacy. I'm Rashmi Arora, Assistant Professor of Pharmacology. Today we'll discuss with you the drugs acting on the uterus. Let us begin with the classification. There are two types of categories of drugs which are acting on uterus. First are uterine stimulants and another are tocolytics, or we can say that they are uterine relaxants. Under uterine stimulants, we have three major drugs: oxytocin, prostaglandin analogs, and ergotalkaloids. And under tocolytics, we have lot of drugs like beta agonist, magnesium sulfate, progesterone, calcium channel blocker nifedipine. Then we have the uterine stimulant antagonist like oxytocin antagonist and prostaglandin antagonist. Let us take up uterine stimulants first. The first and foremost drug and very important drug under this category is oxytocin. Oxytocin basically contracts the myoepithelial cells of breast and let the milk ejected. The major stimuli of milk ejections are either baby cry or the suckling of nipple by baby. However, oxytocin mainly contracts the uterus during the delivery time, and it is insensitive in early pregnancy. It doesn't show any kind of contractility behavior in early pregnancy cases, but its sensitivity increases with the increase in time, or when the pregnancy gets advanced up near the delivery stage, then the patient can feel the contractility behavior of oxytocin, which gets maximum at the time of delivery. It has slight antidiuretic like hormone activity, and the role of oxytocin in man is still unexplained. It is available in the injection form, pitocin. The mechanism of action by which oxytocin act in the body is through G protein coupled receptor IP3 DAG pathway, under which the increased intracellular calcium ion leads to the contractility of muscle. The surface receptors present on the surface of uterus, they are basically also governed by the oxytocin receptor, which is G protein coupled, and along with that, voltage sensitive calcium ion channels, which gets open up when the oxytocin attaches to the surface receptor. And ultimately, the opening of calcium sensitive voltage gated channels along with the receptor activation causes the depolarization of uterine muscles, and thus contractions takes place. While converting from TIP2 to diacylglycerol, also IP3 gets released up, inositol triphosphate. This inositol triphosphate then act on the endoplasmic reticulum on which the receptors are present, and this also causes the calcium-induced calcium release, sequestering of intracellular storage of calciums, and thereby increasing the level of calcium inside the cell, and hence leads to the contractility behavior. It also increases the prostaglandin release on the other hand. The clinical uses of oxytocin include induction of labor, which is a drug of choice in this case, and usually intravenous infusions are given in units. It is also used in postpartum hemorrhage. However, ergotalkaloids are the best choice against oxytocin. Nowadays, desaminooxytocin buccal tablet is also available to treat the post hemorrhage conditions in the dose of 25 to 50 international units. Intranasal preparation to be used in case of breast engorgement, and also it is acting as abortifacient. Abortifacient is basically a drug or a device which is used to cause the abortion. Intravenous infusion of more than 20 weeks of gestation is required if we want to use oxytocin as abortifacient. However, it is ineffective, as we have earlier talked about the oxytocin, that it is not effective in case of early pregnancy stages. So it is ineffective in early pregnancies. It won't give abortifacient effect in early pregnancy. Side effects of oxytocin. The major side effect is the rupturing of uterus, which is more serious side effect. Also along with that, due to its antidiuretic hormone like activity, water intoxication and hypertension may result. For that specific oxytocin antagonist, Tocibam is effectively used in the management of premature delivery. Tocibam is behaving as an tocolytic agent. It relaxes the uterine muscles. Then comes the second type of drugs under the uterine stimulant category are prostaglandins, in which dinoprostan and dinoprost, which are prostaglandin E2 and F2 alpha analogs respectively. They are basically used as abortifacient and to induce the labor pains. However, they are available in vaginal pessaries, gels, tablets, or IV infusion and intramyotic preparations. Carbapose and Gempros are also PGF2 alpha analogs, and they are used as intramuscular or intramyotic way to induce abortion or postpartum, or to control the postpartum hemorrhage. However, Gempros is used as vaginal pessaries and mainly used to prime the cervix portion. Then comes the ergot alkaloids. Ergot alkaloids, ergonovine, methyl ergonovine, which are available in intramuscular and oral preparations. They remain the drug of choice in managing the postpartum hemorrhage over the oxytocin, however. As compared to oxytocin, these are more potent agents and they show the prolonged and sustained contraction of uterus. Ergot alkaloids, however, contraindicated during the delivery because they may cause the fetal distress and mortality. Increase in the mortality rate of fetus takes place if we use ergot alkaloids or if we replace oxytocin with ergot alkaloids for sustained contractions. So it is contraindicated in case of at the time of delivery. However, it can be used to treat postpartum hemorrhage better over the oxytocin. Then comes the uterine relaxants or tocolytics. The drugs are indomethacin, nifedipine, which is a calcium channel blocker, then magnesium sulfate, and terbutane or terbutaline, which is beta agonist agent. The major clinical use of tocolytics is in premature delivery. It won't allow the premature delivery. However, it relaxes the uterine muscles and thus improves the survival of the newborn. So the first category which we are going to discuss is beta adrenergic agonist, in which retordrine and terbutaline are the agents. And these agents, they basically act via G protein coupled second messenger cyclic AMP system. They increases the level of cyclic AMP, thereby decreasing the cytoplasmic calcium ion concentration and thus relaxes the muscles. And intravenous infusion of retordrine is most widely used. However, terbutaline is available as oral, subcutaneous and intravenous administration. The side effects of beta-adrenergics are sweating, tachycardia and chest pain. Then is magnesium sulfate as a tocolytic agent. IV infusion of magnesium sulfates activates the adenylate cyclase and stimulate the calcium ion dependent ATPase, and thus helps in maintaining the newborn's sustaining life, and it inhibits the premature delivery and convulsions of preeclampsia. Then progesterone orally and intramuscularly, dihydrogesterone, they are also used. And then we have the oxytocin competitive antagonist Atosiban, which we have already discussed in the previous slides. And then prostaglandin inhibitors are indomethacin and meloxicam, which comes under the non-steroidal anti-inflammatory agents. they also blocks the contractility behavior arises due to the prostaglandins. And then the calcium ion channel blockers itself, which are voltage gated calcium ion channels, they can be blocked by nifedipine. And the major contraindication to nifedipine as a tocolytic agent is the fetal distress. So we don't use it at the time of delivery. So these are some points and the drugs which are used to act on the various conditions of uterus or at the time of delivery or to cure the postpartum hemorrhage like conditions or used as abortifacient, etc. I hope this will give you clear information about the topic. Thank you from now.